What's up, Teague? Howdy, man. And welcome everyone else, too. The YouTube and the Twitch and everything. Welcome, people. Today I'm working on some story elements. Right now I'm working on this where Zero walks off the screen with your sword. There's a lot more to this story element that I want to do, but this is the beginning of it for now. This is all I really have time for today. You're on green light! Yes! Let's see it, man. Where's the link? Yeah, so there's going to be one more story element here where he actually uses his telekinesis skill to steal your sword. So when you wake up here, the sword's on the ground, Zero walks on the screen, uses his telekinesis to steal your sword, and then walks off. I wish I had time to do that today, but I got so many bugs on my list and I got to release tonight, so. Nice. Let's check this out, man. Ahoy, Salad Dongs, Arcane, what's up? Hello, hello. Swarmonian Explorer. Yes, nice. We do the animated GIF. Got your videos all set up, screenshots. Good job, Teague. What's up, Adam Hunter? Welcome, man. So, to finish off this little scene here with Zero walking away with your sword, this kind of gives you the impression that he stole your sword. I just need to make it so it runs even when it's opening up everything. So, like you see here, it waits until the scene is finished opening before he starts walking. But I want it to start right when the scene is at its very most start, so that by the time he's done walking, he's pretty much all the way off the screen. Hello, Hey Siri. Welcome. So I'm at this point where what is causing him to not run? Because he already has his run while paused flag, so he should be running. Did I finish the blink? Yeah, oh yeah, I should show you guys the blink. The blink is sick. You guys gotta see this. Let's see if it just works here in this dungeon. I think I have the blink. Yeah. Yeah, it works in every direction. I did some brand new animations for the north-south. And also you can double tap. Oh, I forgot about that. I can double tap a direction. And he'll use the blink, so you don't even have to use the button if you're fast with the double tap. Or you can use the button just as normal, so I can use my regular keyboard. I'm using my keyboard right now. Of course, you can use controller too. Anybody else out there doesn't know that? It's a controller-based game, basically, mostly. But while I'm holding down a direction, I can use the blink button. So I've got blink bound to my G key right here. So I can blink that way or blink by double tapping. So it's working pretty well. Oh, you guys don't have sound, do you? Sorry about that. Whoops, you need the sound effect. That's important. Can you blink diagonal? Yes, you can. There's no blink diagonal graphics, but oh, you did have sound? What? Well, that's cool. I'm glad you had sound. Yeah, totally. I agree, Teak. It's super cool how you're doing the particle based. Okay, so he should be running. Why is he not running? I know there's a flux running as well, but he should still move. All right, AI system. Let's see where he actually. Behavior direction, where it's setting his initial direction. There it is. Let's set a breakpoint there and see when that happens. If it happens right at the beginning, we know that it's actually setting the direction and it's not just honoring the movement of it. Yeah, see, here it is. It's hitting it right here. If this is the right. Yeah, this is zero. So it's his last compass direction. So he's getting a direction right away. He must just not be moving until. Yep, he's got north. Yeah. So the next thing on the list would be to check if it's getting into the method where it applies input. It does look like it's there. Same guy. Yeah, this is zero. His AI direction is still north. Let's go into the set button down and see if this works. It's going to set button up to be down. Nah, it immediately said it. Okay, so I know that he's getting his direction. He's even getting his input being set down. It's just that he's not moving. So if I let this run, yeah, he totally had direction the whole time. Okay, so I'm guessing maybe the move system is disallowing him from doing anything. All right, and let's go back to AI system, grab this little bit of code I was using to debug. Okay. Let's see if he has his direction already set. Not yet. Let's see if the next tick. The next tick. Okay, the very next tick, he has his direction. Should be running. Now, why is he not actually performing any movement at this point? He resets his compass direction, but he should get another one soon. Okay, we get past the paused. He resets his idle timer because we are paused. All right, there. He grabbed his compass direction, so his move component should now have nothing. Oh. Here's the problem. Okay, I need to peer into that method. We should have up, true. Doesn't though. Oh. This is button down, checked, ignored, lock. Here we go. This is exactly why. Oh, found it. Nice. Okay, that's what it is. He wasn't applying his input right there. This is an input component. When it gets its compass direction, we need a bool ignore lock in this method. All right, yes, found it. Cool, yeah, flying. Got to get a lot done today. Kind of pressured, hurried, worried. Okay, compass direction. Ignore lock. Think did release button also has its. Yeah, it has an ignoring lock as well, so I'll add that. All right, now the last thing is to just you go to the back to the move system, and we need some better logic about how to ignore whether it should ignore the lock. In fact, yeah, we've already checked if the if it's paused, we already continue out of this loop. So this should always be false or true. Ignore locking. And that probably is the only call of this method. Yeah, it's the only call. Okay, I could have just written it straight into the method without this. But anyways, true. That's cool. Still didn't work though. Why? Bet it's closer though. All right, once again, set a breakpoint. He's not gonna have his direction just yet. Or maybe he does. Wait, E. Yeah, he doesn't have a direction. The next time he does. All right. Second call. Stepping in. Stepping in. Should have ignore lock, true. If ignore lock or not paused, find that button. Did you press it? Please say yes. Oh, nice. It worked. Okay, yeah, so he's pressing the up key. Oh. Wait, does it work? Does this work? Find latest directional button input. No, it didn't. This method breaks. my god. Here it is. Once again, checking his button down. All right, find latest directional button. Also needs a bool ignore lock. I believe button times should always be being set. Yeah, it always sets the button down. It just doesn't always. Okay, this should work now. Boogie, what's up, man? How you been? How's everything, Boogie? Subspace my name. Okay, this time, second time running through the loop. We'll see if he gets his direction. True, but these are checking diagonals. Oh, it didn't work. Oh, because I didn't pass it in. Ignore. Lock. You're getting there. Oh, nice. It finally worked. Yay. Yeah, all right. He's walking at the very beginning. That's all I wanted to see this whole time. Yes. Freaking works. Okay, I'm gonna see that was. Hey, there you go. 3 points. You're ahead. I think you need some kind of mirage effect to go out. Or at least a fade out. All right, so this frame, we'll put it like 80, 60, 40, 20. Yeah, 80, 60, 40, 20 ought to do. There, so now he'll fade out instead of just disappearing. Zero fade, sword, north. Hold on a second. I might not even need this animation. There's something which removes entities like instantly. But maybe instead of removing the entity instantly, it could fade it out. Move entities. I think she had, yeah. Wait. I have a render flag for this. I do. I have to write a research paper? Oh. Yeah, K-Render fade out. See if it works. Common dilemma. Right? Oh. Yeah, that worked. It worked. It worked. It worked. That's good enough. That's totally good enough. If I happen to get up and run fast enough for him to be gone off the screen, or if I run off the screen and see him, at least he's fading out. Come back with my sword! Oh, what happened? Is working well. How about if I run off the screen in the other way to the right? I think it should delete his entity. He shouldn't be here anymore. Cool. It works well. I like it. I like it. I like it. So let me delete that file I just created. I don't need. Get rid of this. Close that. All right, adding in the files I just created for this little story effect. Fade sword north. Oh, this is the one I don't need. I just want to add run sword north. Okay, now I'm gonna just check over everything, make sure I didn't break or possibly break anything. Let me just make sure he still works on the overworld. Oh, and I also want to remove any. Before I do that, I want to remove any debug code or whatever I was writing. Which probably is still in the move system. Yeah, move system is all okay. be back at zero. I just want to make sure he still appears on the screen. Oh, there he is. Took him a while to appear. Come back. Who are you? What are you doing? Why do you have big horns on your head? Oh, no, sword. Yes, I love seeing that. I love seeing that. Oh, I love seeing him walk off screen with your sword. So cool. Alright, this is worthy of checking in. I just checked all this, but let me just check it again. We don't need swords. Yeah, where we're going, we don't need swords. Not in here, no. Three didn't, I just didn't work out, but four, right? I should check that. Make sure. This still works to blowing up. Oh no, Teeks! Oh man! What is that, the fifth or sixth time? The sixth time I think you failed. Man, that sucks! Oh! Oh yeah, that was cool. Actually, I want to see that some more. I want to see some psychedelic effect going on. That would sound be so unlikely, but in your case, I don't know. Oh, Jim disappeared right then. Yes, I like seeing that. Awesome, that looked cool. But why does Jib disappear right then? doesn't matter. I can't fix a million things at once. Get this checked in. There's always something to be glad for, right, Arcane? Alright, that is one thing checked off my list. I wanted to see. Oh, I still haven't even finished that scene. Oh well. Alright, I want to do this stuff. I want to focus on the dialogue for the rest of today's stream. What's up, the gaming artist? The dialogue is kind of abrupt. There's a bunch of points where it's like it doesn't start at the right times and it's not that refined. Brutus's dialogue. Let's put that one top. Refine Brutus's dialogue. To do this, I'm going to start a new game. Thanks, gaming artist. Yeah, so Boogie. Oh, that's a new thing, Boogie. Yeah, you can start in the desert. It's something I added with the latest code. Basically, it swaps the styles. It doesn't change the world seeds at all. So all worlds are exactly the same. It just goes and swaps out the style for the beginning section. And the beginning section is a lot more contained now, so it pretty much guarantees that you have in that. Well, it does guarantee that in the first section, you find Zero's cave. You can also find the first dungeon, and you're basically contained inside because there's bombable pillars on the all the way on the outsides of the everything. So it should be a lot less likely as a new player to this game that you would ever get lost. You know what I mean? That you would have a bad experience by just wandering around endlessly. You can't really wander that far. You can only wander through like a quarter of the overworld until you get the bombs. So that should be better too. There's a few things I want to do. I want it to automatically zoom in when it does text. But Brutus is that. Let's go to Brutus's dialogue first. In fact, Brutus's dialogue might need to be sooner. I've not gotten the top hat, mini boss. Dude, I've wandered around so much. Oh, I don't have the sword. I'm like, why? So I guess Zero should not even appear. If you don't have a sword. Or the top hat, or the bombs. What's up, Zyger? Okay, so now I'm gonna wander around. I should not encounter Zero. Very good. Next, I'm going to get the sword. Was still visible during that. Okay, I beat the sword boss. I don't want to. Home two and that. Don't want either of those. I want Jib's text to be a little bit more random, too. So there, like 20% of his letters won't be random or won't be alien. In addition to vowels and just the beginning of the line and all that. Oh. Oh. D-Rand. Okay, now he should have 20% of his text not alien randomly. Oh, I understand. This is based on. This is called twice. Once for each. Once for each font or whatever. You just ran face first into some of the fun times you were talking about in regards to there not really being any good debuggers. Oh yeah, couldn't find out why something wasn't rendering. You found it? Did you figure it out, man? Did you figure it out? You didn't capitalize one of the letters? Oh, man, I know, right? The stuff like that. That's the worst part about writing shaders is, like, the little bugs you have no very direct knowledge about. I know, it always does, right? There, all right. None of his letters in that one, though. I bought him tea. Increase this random percentage to 30. Talk, man. All right, let's get we'll get the top hat. Yep, Jib speaks English. He does. Yeah, Alex Pita. What's up, man? Hello, Zio. Dialogue immediately after this encounter. That's what I'm talking about. Dialogue being abrupt. Bella! Thanks, PETA. Thanks, appreciate you saying that. So this is where I'm at right now. I'm working on refining the story, especially the initial story. The first like 30 minutes of you playing the game, I really want the story to be dialed in and awesome. This is the part I'm talking about right here, where it's kind of abrupt in the sense that I just fought this enemy, and immediately after that battle, it just played me some dialogue, paused the screen and all that. So, I need a way to delay this dialogue. Oh. He always called twice in a row. Hey, Dad? Hey, I'm I just want to say I'm live streaming right now. I'm in the middle of some work, so I'm live on the internet. So what is there something going something on? Is this a merge? Yeah, okay. Awesome. So you're headed off on you're in Miami, heading out right now? Okay. Cool, Dad. Well, I wanted to say I'm so excited for you. And it's going great. Yeah. Yeah. All right, Dad. Well, I love you. Thanks for the call. Thanks for letting me know. Okay, bye-bye. So how to delay this? Like the player just fought an enemy on this screen. It really shouldn't. I mean, there are other cases where. It's like the story system should have a cooldown. Oh, maybe that's what it'll have. Like a cooldown before it can run further actions. And it could erase its cooldown if it gets onto a new screen, or maybe you just. Okay, I want to see this all. I want to see this all again, over and over, until I fix this. We should have enough positions now. We're at this right position. As long as I, what's the find level one was the text he was just saying, and the top hat, put that to zero. Thanks, you guys. All right, cool. Look at that, he immediately said his dialogue, even though I already have a flux going. I can't see his text all the way. Right, there are many ways to delay this system. I'm trying to think of a good way to do this. Well, let's open up the te this text and stuff. Check in what we got so far. What's up, Pedro? Welcome, man. Story system has its as a built-in timer. Waiting for flux. That's right. Waiting for flux. Sometimes it waits for flux, sometimes it doesn't. All right, one thing that could, since this system waits for the flux only if it wants to, there needs to be a way that other systems can say, hey, you should wait for the flux, man. Like if you pick up an item or gear or whatever. Don't know. Basically, you should never have to. Yeah, Boogie, it already has an actions queue. Yeah, there's already an actions queue. It's a complex system because this action item right here is something where an NPC can give you yeah, fluxes, dialogues, animations, everything are yeah, there's already all that stuff is already in an action queue. It's this variable here, the vector of story actions. It's just that it's a complex system because sometimes I want it to wait for a flux, the whatever, like he's giving you an item or whatever. Sometimes I don't. Like for when you're when it gives you an item straight from the story. So it's complex. But maybe I'm just making it too complex. Maybe I'm overthinking all this. Like, hell, maybe this will just work now. I don't know I haven't even tested this recently. The waiting for flux was only used in one instance anyways. What if I took this all the way out? What if I didn't even have this anymore? This whole complexity of waiting for flux. Well, can you just add a bool to the story action true equals wait? Oh, now you got a good idea here. Yes, I like that. Right? 'Cause this action, yeah, instead of having a waiting for flux as a global or whatever, it would just be part of each action, would wait conditionally. Depending on the action. Yeah, that's a really good way to do it. Because let's see if this breaks. If this breaks the Brutus giving you the item. Oh, it breaks that guy when he initially appears. Because you don't want to wait for. Yeah, you're totally right. You're totally right. Each action should have its own conditional condition whether it should wait. Good call, Boogie. Very good call. We'll wait for flux. Oh, Aura, yeah, time. Thank you. Thank you. Yes, actually, that's probably even better. No, well, oh, yeah. It could be whatever it needs to be. And then if it's negative, that would be wait forever. Wait until. No, it doesn't need a timer. It doesn't need a timer if I, because. Or, no, you're right. Yeah. After the flux is, yeah, exactly what you just said there. After the flux finishes, wait a certain amount of time. That could be very useful, actually. Okay. Good call. So waiting zero is no need to wait. Good call, Boogie. What's this? Case story action delay. Right, yeah. Wait zero, wait negative one, don't wait at all. Right. But this might be something I already started doing at case story action day. See, delayed action keys. Cool. This is exactly where I'll work all this in. I already kind of had this concept right here. If you can run the action. So I've got these delayed action keys. These are things that definitely need to wait. Let me turn this into a map, I guess, for now. String to double. Action delays. So like dialogue, for example, would wait. Lens would wait. Bruce Bob, what's up, man? Delayed action keys isn't to wait before showing the action key on the dialogue bubble, is it? No, no, that's not. No, it's the overall action. Why are you using doubles for time when C++ has the chrono time library? I don't know. I've never even heard of the chrono time library. But it sounds complicated to me. Why would I use something more complicated than double? Double's pretty simple. All right, so wait. All right, so there now it grabs its an action delay based on its key and everything. And I think the place to do this might actually be here to tick down its timer, run action. The chrono library defines three main types: durations, clocks, and time points, as well as utility functions and common type defs. Well, I guess the one reason that I could think of that I wouldn't want to use that is that every time you include something else in your project, it takes longer to compile. You know, I spent a whole weekend refining my libraries.h and making sure that nothing in here was causing too much compile time increase. This is the bare bones minimum I can get by making a game triple platform, cross platform on three different compilers. And getting it all to work well. Even just adding like one additional header right here adds seconds to my overall build time. So that's one reason I wouldn't use it. That's what I meant by it being complicated. It's just that every single C++ header is all templated and type defed and all this stuff that is takes a long time to compile. String, for example. String is like, not, yeah, templated. It's, everything is templated, which means that the C++ compiler has to process it many times. You know, you don't, every time it includes, every time it builds a CPP file, there's 62 C++ files in Songbringer. Every time it compiles one of those, even though it might have a prefix header already, even or a pre-compiled header already, it's already read that header. It's already kind of processed it a little bit. It still has to go create a string every single time because it's templated. It might be a little different for that C++ file, for all the compiler knows. So it's a lot of work. That's probably one of the biggest drawbacks of C++. Headers. Anyways, I'm digressing. Where was I? Man, I've really lost focus today. Can hardly think. I don't know why. Contains delayed action keys, right? That's where you'd, oh, right. So the run action method, if story system run action, it needs its fixed delta. So weight zero doesn't weight at all. Out of interest, how much yes votes did Songbringer have after the first day? I have no idea, man, but I posted all those on the TIG source, and also as Kickstarter updates, so you can probably find them. You can probably find my stats. Sorry, I don't really have time to go find those stats right now. So this did push back a new action. If the But it's not about waiting until the next action. It's about waiting for the flux that's currently running. So that's what I'm thinking about. I'm thinking about the zero and the negative one, which it doesn't really matter which one and which man, I can barely think today. Anyways, but by saying that, I'm making myself think even worse. So I need to start saying things like, "I can think all I want today, like a badass. I'm a super duper awesome thinker." That's right. All right. If this thing has a action dot wait. It's not equal to zero. Right, so but I want the default. I think he's neat. Yeah. I want the default for most actions to be zero. You know, I've already got zero. So zero, it means zero means there is no waiting whatsoever, which is already done. Okay, so negative, anything less than zero means that you have to wait. You know what? No, it just needs a positive weight. It just needs zero or positive because you can wait. The positive waits until the flux is finished and then the timer has elapsed. Let me just write this down. So if weight is greater than zero and we're not fluxing, There. So now it's eating up its weight. All right. It also needs to wait for the player to be in the middle of the screen, and I guess that should be part of this logic here. Well, let's see if this is anywhere near right. Did work. We gave it a little delay before it ran that. And I see what happens with that story action. That story action was where he says it's getting late, we should go look for a songbringer. Find level one. Yeah, all right, yeah, that proves it. Okay, so you have to have the item zero for that dialogue to come up. So I think this just worked. Because it waits until I've obtained the top hat, but it also waits until the flux is finished. If I get this and I just hang out here forever, I let this flux run as long as I want. Let's do like another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah, of course it's not triggering that dialogue. Now, after I close this, it should wait 1.6 seconds before it runs the next action. Good. All right. You had a longer delay? Could try a longer delay, sure. So dialogue in general would wait like, let's say 5 seconds. thinking something? Thinking. Gotta put on my thinking cap. Oh, yeah. Oh, there's something else, right? Oh, yeah, I had a feeling we were both like... It's probably crazy hard to be watching somebody else's live stream and watching them code and to provide good, like, suggestions and stuff because you don't know all the code. You don't know what I've written recently, for example. Like, maybe you did totally pay all the attention in the world and you know exactly what's going on, but maybe I changed something in the last hour before today's stream or something like that. So, yeah, must be hella hard. So thank you, man. Thanks for the effort. Appreciate it. As always. So it should wait 5 seconds. Yeah. Cool. It's super tricky. Yeah, man. You're in the zone right now. You're like in the super duper zone to be able to focus on somebody else's code and provide such a great suggestion. I'm telling you. It's amazing. Boogie's got the flow right now. You should go buy like some lottery tickets and stuff or do some risky things. Oh, I want to go off the screen. I didn't quite make it. Skydiving. Yes, have you always wanted to do that? Today's your day, man, I'm telling you. You have the best skydiving experience ever. So if I hang out like right here on the edge of the screen where I'm just about to move off, you don't actually want to do that? I should be able to walk off this screen. Yeah, it did a long, long delay though. Oh wait, no, this is the other text. Oh, I don't think it ran that text. Either that, or maybe it reset the text. Oh no, it ran it here because it was originally run on this screen. It was waiting. Okay, now that's something I should test again. Too scurry. Alright, yeah, I'll just go off the screen. So it's 5 seconds that it would have delayed. Oh, it must have run part of its delay already, too. Rigged. I guess it's kind of a minor detail, though. Well, is it? Should it reset its waiting? I guess it probably should. There's something where it's like, it's area, pause. Ah. What's up, Silly Billy Bear? Welcome, man. So if this action is of the wrong area, that needs to be reset. So make a public function set weight or reset weight. So now we can call this again later. Yeah, so it'll reset its wait time. If you go off the screen and it's not the right area and it's trying to run an action, it keeps it in the queue. It's ready. It's like, okay, I remember that I need to play this certain story element, but it's got to be at this certain area that it started at, because, you know, that's just how the system could totally break itself if it runs like a certain action that needs to be run on a certain area, and that's pretty much happens to every single area. So every single kind of action. So this will, if it does try and run an action that's off screen, it just resets its wait timer and then says, no, it can't run. Oh, this is supposed to return false. Oh, yeah. What if it starts a conversation? Wait a minute. If this is just named improperly, that's all. Okay, what if it starts a conversation, you walk off screen after a couple dialogues, is the entire conversation... No, it doesn't start the whole thing over. It just delays running the next step in the dialogue or the next story. I need some college assistance real quick. What you need, man? Not on the screen yet. I wait a while. It will have used up part of its time. Come back on here. 1-1000. Yeah. Okay, did it. But let's go back to like a 5 second delay. Try that again. Okay, 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000. There, I just ate up 3 seconds of it. I walked off screen. It should reset. I go back on here. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5-1000. All right, so it worked. It reset that timer. Cool. That's good. I think this system's right now. So I leave the screen, go to a dungeon far, far away, randomly come back and pick up in the middle of a conversation. Yes. But that's, see, you shouldn't actually be able to leave a conversation though, because you have to press the key to get through it. So most of the time that's never ever gonna happen. It's just like, if the worst were to happen and you somehow got off of the current area, it shouldn't continue the current story on a different area because it might not be applicable to the current area. So most of the time that'll never happen. I think this is ready to be checked in. But let's go try it out with Brutus and then I'll start again from the beginning. Yeah, once it starts, you're gonna finish it. Probably, yeah. Barring some really weirdness. Showed the HUD. What did it do there with the HUD? So I'm deciding between two places, a community college leading up to a good university. And then going straight to the university is a second. I'm interested in computer science at the moment, desiring to one day become a software engineer. The second college has an accredited computer science major, teaching multiple languages and different aspects of coding. You mean the straight to university? So my question is, why is the first one even an option? Why would you want to go to the community college? Fade out. There it goes. Press this button. Oh, it pings the HUD as soon as it returns control of the player. Wasn't that abrupt that time? I don't know. I'm just gonna proceed. Whatever you do, you definitely don't want to bother with any program that isn't accredited. Oh, yeah. The first university does not have an accredited computer science program and actually has a lot of engineering courses, which looks like I'll be taking instead of some coding. Yeah, so my question is, why would you even be considering the first one? Well, not why would you be even, but what is it that you are interested in at this first college? Why is it on your radar? What is it you like about it? You must like something about it, otherwise you're not considering it. So what is that? What is that part of? And this is really a personal question, you know? It's like only you can answer it. Brutus. Oh, there he is. A super weird place to appear. He's not talking. Make that beta. Thing is, hard as I have a bunch of people I know are going to the accredited one that I don't like, but there are also some I do like. The first one appeals to me because I have one friend going who's the most like me out of all my friends. Oh, so it's about friends. Okay, that makes sense to me. Right. Wait a minute. Did you just play this? Back. So, oh, you're just afraid you would enjoy the first one more, but you're afraid you would learn less. Now see, now I understand your dilemma. And I don't know if I really got any good advice for you here, man. I don't know what to tell you. Does anybody else got any advice? That's a good point. Sal Dongs does bring up an incredible point right here, Silly Billy Bear. You never really know what you're gonna get once you go to the university, you know? You might find that going to the university where you thought that you wouldn't like it as much as far as the friendships, you might end up actually really loving it. You know, you should consider that. Right, that whole sequence still worked. That was good. I think it might have delayed a little bit too long, though. It's almost like this guy really needs to hit you with his dialogue right away. Yeah. So the Billy Bear, whatever you choose, man, whatever you choose, it's gonna be awesome in the end. It will. You'll find a way to make it awesome. Yeah. It is. I know how you feel, man, making these tough life choices, but just realize that in the end, no matter what, you can make your situation reflect who you are on the inside, right? As long as you keep just being who you are, you're gonna meet people, you're gonna make cool friends, you're gonna get through the situ those, you know. It's all gonna be good, man. You boogie, yeah, you never went. I never finished. Why didn't he appear? Oh, because I already have the biodetector. Once I finish making the game, will I still stream? Yes. Yeah, university is more expensive here than, especially than in Europe. Yeah, it's a pretty expensive place. Yeah, boogie, dude, boogie in Europe, going to university is like a quarter to an eighth of the of our cost. Maybe more, maybe less. I mean, you're going for round two at university? Nice, sal dogs. Near free, that's so awesome. Why isn't this guy triggering? Have the sword, you don't have item one, you have 12 positions, you're not at an entrance, refill, home, or gate. Item one is the biodetector. Some countries pay students? Really? Why don't I live there? You could join the military. That's right. You get paid to do that. Wow. Oh, because it gave me, I took off, gave me the Brutus one story item. All right, that wasn't natural coming to it from this screen. Okay, so if I just try and ignore this guy and run past him, oh, okay. Still kicks in the dialogue at an appropriate time. Right, I want to refine his dialogue. And I think this code is working too. I'm going to check this in. I never knew that about university costs. I know, right? Gosh. What's up, Paul Six? Right, that feeling. So much better than it used to be. This dialogue used to be pretty cheesy. Like, it was conveying. I hate it when video games convey something like, okay, the video game needs you to find this certain area or whatever and destroy some enemy. I hate it when they make it too obvious, and this dialogue was too obvious. It was really cheesy, so I'm glad it's refined now. Okay, and it also waits at 1.68 seconds or whatever after you've left the area where you can't engage in dialogue. Yes, silly Billy Bear, I will. No, actually, what I'm thinking about doing as far as like what's next on the radar after Songbringer, I'm actually thinking like I'm gonna release Songbringer sometime this year. But I think I might actually do an expansion pack, and I wanted to run that by everybody and see what your thoughts were on it. Like, I guess it would be a DLC type thing. It would be inexpensive, like half the price of the game. So if the game's $16, it would be like $8 for this expansion pack. And then I would work a lot more on Songbringer and give it tons more stuff, like more items, more secrets, more biomes, more NPCs. And so if you paid for the expansion pack, you have the $8 thing. It's just like an even deeper, sweeter world. So I don't know. That's what I'm thinking. That's of course if Songbringer is a financial success. If it's not, there's no choice. I have to go get a job, 'cause it's there's some things we gotta pay for. It did work out for Isaac, right? Content pack would be cool. All right. All right, that felt a lot better. That good. I like that dialogue a lot better now. Okay, I can check that in too. That's a couple things checked off the list. I'm getting hungry too, Bafu. Yes, exactly. It's all contingent on the success of the game. DLC only if you can fly Songbringer and crash it into the planet. Awesome. That would be so cool. Okay, Brutus's dialogue refined, and also the dialogue is less abrupt. Oh, and I want it so you can't dismiss a dialogue until like after 0.2 seconds or whatever. All right, I could swing that too. Space shooter extension. So there's this flag where it's waiting for input. What is up with all that key in and switch in data? It's the data for the save game. It would depend on this content, I guess. If there's more story, I'd say it'd be worth it. Or a way to learn more lore. Yeah, I'm pretty sure there will be tons of that. Pretty sure. Now I can definitely make sure that there is tons of that. If the game succeeds and it's expansion worthy, then hell yes, I can add more lore. Who's the captain anyways? Oh, he's one of the characters I've designed. He plays guitar. Is this guitar playing captain with like a funny hat? There's so much stuff I've designed, but I have so little time to put in right now because there's more important things to put in the game. Like I got to finish the bosses, got to finish the enemies and all these, you know, the things that are more important. But yeah, the captain. Yes. The captain is a girl too. The captain is a girl character that plays guitar. Oh, I got it. It tracks your time that you. More important than the captain? Cool, Spaceman Name, I'm glad. What more do you plan on adding in terms of polish? That's a really general question. And what do you mean? Before the game is released or after the game is released? Are we still talking about the expansion or are you talking about the game? Okay, that didn't work. Smill each user a container of car wax for their monitors? I mean, is most of the work which is left for the polishy stuff? Or are there more features? Oh, there's a ton more features. Yeah, there's a lot more features that have to get into the core Songbringer game. Like I was just mentioning, the bosses are not finished. The enemies are not finished. The story's not finished. The NPCs are not finished. There's a lot more. There's a lot of mechanics that are not finished. There's like gate items. There's other items that are not finished. So there's still a lot of features left to be implemented. All right, there. I think that now that waiting for input is based on time, so I shouldn't be able to rip through dialogue as fast. Like accidentally miss stuff. Yeah. So now there's a half second delay between all those. It's pretty good. But the 0.5 is a magic number, so. So release date wise, approximately when do you plan on releasing it this year? I can't tell you, man. I don't know. I got to get all the features implemented and make sure all of that checks out and stuff. But I will be setting an official release date at some point, right? Once I'm closer to the end and I see that the end is in sight, right? Like the most of the features are done, the game's almost ready, then it'll be time to set a release date and start promoting the release and getting mostly into marketing mode at that point. Constable, wait for input delay, 0.5. You moved the release date for your game 6 times? Whoa. What game? What game are you talking about? I like it, but I think it's still too much. I'm going to go half that. So if you really do want to just like skip the dialogue, you don't want to have to wait that long. Yeah, that was a little too fast, I guess. Let's go with a third of a second there. And that code's good enough to check in. It's a platformer called Spikes. Cool, man. All right, I'm going to archive this one. Dialogue is no longer as abrupt, and it cannot be dismissed until after a little bit. Yeah, all right, that's good. The next thing I would want to do on today's I'm pretty much done for today's stream. But I need to make the story now so it zooms in on notable things. That's another little type of story action that I'd like to see happen. Instead of there being dialogue all the time, there should be some story elements where it just zooms in. All it does is zooms in on something and kind of just shows you that that is a notable thing. You should just recognize that this is something. And then that way, a lot more things can be conveyed without handholding. Dynamic puzzly elements emergent. Sweet, dude. You've remade the engine 12 times? Wow. All right, guys. Well, I got to get some food. I'm starving. I got a lot of work left today. I'm getting ready to release the game tomorrow. So tomorrow is going to be another release day for Songbringer. Beta updates coming out on Steam. By Saturday morning, for most of y'all who are playing the game, you'll be able to play the game by Saturday morning-ish, something like that. So I got a lot more things I need to get done on before I even release this beta update. I'd like to get through like another eight or so of these elements if possible, especially these purple ones. These are really important. So, anyways, guys, I'm gonna get some food and get back to fixing bugs tonight. And then I'll be back streaming tomorrow. Probably do like a playthrough tomorrow or something. So, yeah, we'll see you guys. See you, everybody.